Snapchat to me the other day, like, I just, like, passed out the fucking floor. And he, like, put a water pit and me on a rope. It was great.
Okay. I don't know from Snapchat.
Yeah.
So,
it's like,
paints.
Microsoft Paints. Yep, Rand.
Well, apparently, I can't do it.
So, Rand at, what is it, 30 feet?
Yeah, 30 feet.
Whatever the maximum.
From 30 feet away, then Rand mage hands that key in.
As you, as the mage hand holding the key gets to the like edge of the depression, the mage hand dispels.
And okay, and it just, okay, well, there's an anti-magic field there, guys, so let's let the new girl do it.
Okay.
So you actually have to do it, like, with your actual hand.
So, I don't care. Wait, I'm
before she does
scared.
It, Brand, the door that could potentially kill her, we don't know what does. We're going to let the person who could only... The only person who could revive us do it. Is that your plan, Rand?
Oh, Soren, okay, thank you for volunteering. You can do it then. Okay,
hold on, I'm just double-checking what your plan was.
I mean, because of really going people's plans, I'm at 1,000.
No, you're fine. I'm like half
your
distracted.
Plans to do it.
Or is there another...
Rand, you're the only person here who has proven to survive death.
Oh.
I've also...
And I can resurrect you.
I also have poison in my veins right now.
Yeah, but you have poison in your veins anyway, you fucking alcoholic.
Guys,
here we go. Rand,
I know, we'll do it.
The only person in the group.
While they're arguing...
I'm not arguing.
Whatever key was on the floor was the larger key. While they're arguing, I'll go ahead and do it.
Okay, while everyone's arguing, Soren goes and puts me in.
Even though you're the one who started the fucking argument. Okay,
wait. Welcome to Alex.
Which key is it?
It was the larger of the two.
It was the big one. Can I have one more? Exactly. Like, so you just throw it at me?
Sweet.
When I say
so
one,
you turn
two.
It...
No. Three. Thank you.
One time. It doesn't seem to happen. Like,
nothing happens.
To happen.
Does it actually turn?
It does turn, yeah.
Just nothing happens? Do I hear anything at all?
You hear some faint clicking, and it does seem...
Is there anything
something.
Around the lock or anything, like, in the area?
Nothing untoward, no.
Like,
what?
Like letters, anything writing-wise, nothing at all?
No.
Because I'm now catching up. What is preventing me from picking this lock?
Well, you haven't tried.
That's true, you technically haven't tried.
And you can't do it with Mage Hand.
I would not suggest it.
Probably not. I'm just saying.
If it's not going to let magic happen, I wouldn't try to force this one.
So then you, you start to hear the faint clicking after one turn. Do you do any more turns?
Was there any writing we had with this when we got the original keys or anything like that that I'm forgetting?
I don't think so.
Just to make sure, like, I want to...
I don't really think that there was. The second key, I believe, you found in the throne room.
The first key was earlier.
Somewhere thereabouts. But there wasn't any, like, text around.
Turn again.
Okay. I'll turn once again.
Again, you hear clicking and the like, but there doesn't seem to be.
But nothing's happening physically.
Okay.
Nothing. You want to try it?
It just sounds like passive clicking.
Yeah.
Sure.
Try the
key.
Other one. Hey, Leah, he's asking for the other key. Give it to him.
Yep.
Okay, cool. So I'll try the smaller key.
Is something going to happen
you
with
the smaller
thing
key.
On the floor?
That's what we're dealing
when
with.
When you turn the first key...
That's where the keyhole is.
Oh, on the floor?
In the indention.
Okay.
Oh, well, then now dice are coming out.
It is, yeah. Give me a second. I gotta do some math here.
Oh.
The key explodes.
Oh, my God, sorry.
Ah!
The key does?
Ah!
Yeah.
Which the smaller the larger.
The small one.
Non-verbal communication. Thank you.
Understandable.
It literally explodes in the hand like a firecracker.
Essentially.
Oh, he keeps picking up more die.
That was 5d6 bludgeoning. Which is... It's 8, 11, 14, 20. 20 points.
20 points?
Yeah.
That's
pretty well.
I'll kill you. Myself, we're good.
Indeed, yeah. It's not a crazy amount.
For when we start fighting things.
Of course, I take like 140
very often.
From the trap.
Okay. You go back to the second.
Might as well.
All right, turn it up. As you finish turning the key, the third time, again, you hear more clicking.
I have a spell that allows me to blink out of existence.
The floor begins to tremble, and then abruptly it starts to rise upward toward the ceiling.
Become a wizard.
I need everyone to roll initiative.
And
Is
that a 20?
Yeah. And D20 plus
initiative.
Your dex.
Which
so
is
it's nothing, so yeah.
11.
9.
Okay, 16.
Okay. Let me get that list set up here. All right.
Are
we going to fight the floor?
Fight something?
What you got?
We might.
25.
That's usually
another?
What
25. Okay.
You're the bomb.
23.
24. Wow.
23.
We're going to go in order.
Yeah.
Damn it. Wait, so the floor just rose up.
It's rising very quickly. What is yours?
9.
9. Okay.
Yeah.
16.
Oh,
no.
As the floor just suddenly starts to rise
what
up.
What is Barks? Why does Bark go with you?
You never gave Bark a... You want me to roll for him?
Sure.
Okay. You never told me that he got... So he got a 9 if it's just straight roll. Because
okay.
You never told me you got a dex bonus of any kind.
Cool. All right. Kyren.
What's happening?
The floor is rising up very quickly. You have enough of a space to move away. You like kind of pop off before it reaches the ceiling.
Okay.
And smashes you to death.
Okay. Then let's do that.
Cool. Are you going to assist anyone else?
Who's having trouble getting off the floor?
Well, no, I'm just saying, it's just a question.
I've got a 9 and I can heal people.
Would he do that?
I mean,
he just bounce off.
He would.
Okay. Who are you going to assist? You already know that some of the other folks are fairly quick about doing things.
Let's help the new person.
Yay!
Okay.
Your full plate armor, just drag you out of there.
Fantastic.
Hey.
Do you
I'm a rogue
allow
of honor.
Yourself to be dragged?
Totally.
Okay. That's good. That's very good.
Wait, what was that?
No.
I'm sorry, what?
I'm sorry, what? I could have sworn I coughed and said Misty Step at the same time.
I'm not wasting a spell slot for a simple
well,
movement.
This doesn't matter until my turn, so. Yeah.
Just keep it in mind.
I know.
Soren.
I know my spells.
I'm running.
Right. Cool.
Good luck, Rand.
Leas.
I say that as
I'll
I run.
Move, like, is it the whole room or is it a circle around that middle part?
It's the whole space. Like, you're gonna have to move away
into the doorway.
Like, hop off.
Yeah, so.
Wait,
I
can't leave Rand.
Yeah,
well,
can't.
It's not
Rand. Says who?
Is Rand within reach of me?
I would say yes.
What about
yeah.
Bark? Can I.
Bark can
as
fly.
As he grabbed me and jerked me
not
out.
Not without his armor
can
activated.
Can
he
I
can't do it
bark,
himself.
Grab Bark's
He's
collar.
He's faster than you.
And jerk Bark out in the nick of time.
Give me
a
serendipity
well.
Roll.
A what roll?
So.
Percentile.
These two.
Okay. All right. Okay, cool. I really want to. I want to say Bark.
Two.
Two. Wow.
I'm going to say no.
I hate these fucking dice. They get real shit.
Welcome to D&D.
You're going to just bounce off?
Sorry, Bark.
I'm going to bounce off and hold my action ready to cast Bigby's hand if I feel like they're in danger.
Interesting. Rand.
How fast is this thing rising? Like, do I even have a chance to react, or do
this
I have to
this
jump
is,
out
this
or go?
This is a reaction.
Run.
Shit.
Run.
This is a reaction.
Run.
What I'm
doing
is
saving me, Alex.
Is based
You're
on
Alex.
Initiative
Jesse.
Rolls, things will happen on a certain initiative number.
I'm never going to save
that
him,
will be.
No.
Okay.
I have a full-time job saving him.
Highly relevant.
So, and I only did it because you're the healer.
Run.
Yeah.
I know.
Yeah,
it takes
Rand.
A while to get on my good side.
It's okay.
You and Bark are going like same time, aren't you?
No. Bark. Bark's initiative is 9.
Bark's next. Right, well, I would assume, but...
No, press the button.
He starts running, hoping that Bark is coming with him, like saying, like, let's go! And just dives towards the exit, running towards it.
So, okay. Got it.
Yeepy
Katie. Okay.
Do I see that Bark's not going to make it?
On initiative count 10.
How's New Jersey? Is it alright?
Anyone still on the
stream
floor is crushed against the roof.
Okay. So
slain.
I use my action that was held to.
Slain.
I'm gonna cure my bark friend.
I can't sweep him out of there.
I would like to use my level 7 resurrection to bring back
to
bark.
Revive bark.
Like master, like dog, like master.
Please. I'm gonna bring him back, buddy. Don't.
No, like this is Rand's reaction at the moment. He's
just so you're saying I can't hold my action to cast Baby's hand at an initiative.
This is all reaction.
Okay.
I've got way too many dog treats to not have a bark
out.
In the group.
Okay.
Because it's shooting up.
Uh-huh.
So right now in the doorway, all I see is just rock.
So I wouldn't
because
have had
no.
To,
no.
I'll explain that in just a second.
So I wouldn't have had time to cast Baby's Hand at all.
No.
Okay.
That's the point.
Uh-huh. But still, Rand is sitting there outside just eye glazed. Nothing.
Yep.
He's just staring.
Do you still have your incense? You want another stick?
Why is his eyes are glazed?
Dog treat?
Too soon. I love terrible too soon.
Must be a cop and he was eating donuts.
So when can I bring back Bark? I have got that level 7 resurrection spell. Now it's just, you know, the right time to use it, I think, so.
Okay, let's do this real quick, and then we'll
step.
Kind of deal with that in just a second.
What would it have done? Gotten me out of the way.
Could have grabbed it. You can bring one
the
with
rising
you.
Of the
I know,
floor
but I was grabbing her.
In the southern part of this room reveals a mithril vault. There is a door in the center of the device with a ring set into it. Rand is probably going to be... comatose?
He is.
For a moment.
He's still not moving, not talking, not anything.
So how long have you, like, you and Bark known each other?
Since we started the campaign.
So, like, what, two and a
half
years?
2.5 years. He's only been awakened for maybe
There's
6
ring
months,
where?
But still.
In the middle of the vault door, the mithril vault door.
Neat.
And, question.
Answer. Daily double.
Give me a serendipity roll.
Me?
Yes.
I'm also sharing.
Probably gonna need you to take over some of this other heavy lifting.
I mean,
tracks.
Rand's reaction.
I know.
23.
Use a luck point and try that again.
Luck point.
Where is it? 23. He faded it away, jumped fucking 7 foot in the air. He was good.
25.
Jesus Christ.
That's 52.
I have one more luck point. I'm going to use it.
Blow on him. Blow it.
24.
He blew it.
Can we add
I've
them
used
together?
I've used every luck point.
Oh, God.
Can we add them together?
Because they are a little consistent.
Can you add them
together? Chaotic stupid was not made up just to make fun of him.
Jesus, that was...
Sarand has died. He's lost his dog.
I am going to bring him back.
No,
no, that means
he died earlier.
Oh,
I have
died. He has died, yeah. He just lost
Now he just suddenly lost his dog.
Maybe I'll just let Bark...
The most happy-go-lucky character has the worst shit happen to him. Okay.
Give me a perception check. This will be relevant for the cleric.
Me? You want me to get a perception check?
No, I'm just saying that what happens next will
That's
be
funny.
Relevant to you for a very specific reason.
Wait,
okay.
Did you ask me for a perception check?
Yes.
One.
Jess.
Call a 10.
I can call a 10. And actually, I'm a halfling. So, oh, no, wait, that's
no.
A 7. Not
okay.
A 1.
So,
call a 10.
25. Okay, there is a,
Jesus Christ.
I love you. Thank you for loving Bark so much.
There is a
The best
gap.
Part of this campaign.
Here's the interesting thing. There is a gap in the ceiling, like, from the slab and the ceiling.
And that's where Bark is.
And you actually notice that the mithril vault isn't all the way up.
Yeah.
Like, this didn't make it all the way to the top.
He's got a suit of armor on that's tough as nails.
Well, the armor wasn't activated necessarily, but we will... you hear... After...
Oh, God, is Bark squealing?
After a long while...
God, that was genuine!
can I flick a dog treat up in the crevice?
You okay?
Just like pouring one out for the homies.
So you throw a dog treat up?
Yeah.
Into the gap.
Yeah.
And you hear very faintly.
Thank you. Rand literally has tears rolling down his face now. Like he's finally reacting, but he is like in tears.
The magical saddle.
Yeah.
Like Bark.
It's kind of like
in
holding it
in a last kind of ditch thing, like flopped over. So like it slammed, and because the saddle is like bigger than him, obviously, because it has to fit around him, it is like holding it. Like he took a pretty decent chunk of damage from that, just from like the shock, but it didn't smash him entirely.
Now, can I try to use a Bigby's hand strength check to budge the vault back down a little bit?
What is the,
27, I think?
So, if you had, like, maybe...
Telekinesis?
Many Bigby's hands, then possibly, yes.
Okay. How big is the... space between the column and the ceiling?
Well, you have to get up there somehow.
Is it
random?
How high
he can
is
walk
it?
Up walls.
It's 25 feet.
Okay.
And
but okay.
Assuming that they're not smooth walls.
I also have Misty Step.
So I was about to say we both have Misty Step.
So you can Misty Step up there and kind of crawl in.
I wouldn't be able to stand, so
can
it's
I
not
use
like
grasping vine to pull the floor back down?
No.
Definitely not grasping vine.
Please.
That's not how it works.
Okay.
No,
what I was going
well,
to say.
I'm useless here, guys.
Climb up there, see how far you need to go. Misty step in to where that's at. Grab him, Misty step out.
I can't bring someone with me, can I?
With Misty step, you can.
I can?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can.
Oh, wait, holy shit, I can?
Yeah, we just have to cast the Misty step twice. Or no, if you just crawl in, you can do it.
No, I just didn't know I could bring someone with me with Misty Step.
I mean, there's nothing in the spell book that says for or against it.
Can I use
it just says briefly
here?
Surrounded. Briefly surrounded by silvery mist, you teleport up to 30 feet to an unoccupied space that you can see.
It would just be you.
It's just me, yeah. That's why
be,
I didn't.
That would be Dimension Door.
That's right.
Well, do we want to have a hero's feast right now?
Yeah.
Being an ass, I'm sorry.
All right.
Please don't listen
so
to me.
So you miss a step up there, and you crawl
in
your way
into Bark,
in to where Bark is.
I pull like just a handful. I just reach into my pocket, pull out like all six my handful of the senzu beans that I had from way back when, and just like here you go, Bark. I'm gonna get you out of here. I'm gonna get out of here. I'm gonna get you out of here, buddy. Just give me 1 second.
There is one obvious way to do it, but you have to leave the saddle behind.
I realize that. I don't care about that. Well, I do, but I do. Rain doesn't.
right.
Shit.
Hmm.
Soren.
What?
Oh!
Throw me that rod.
Wait.
They move a rod?
I have that fancy anointing oil. Can we grease Bark up and jerk him out? Serious question. Totally serious question.
I've already how
he's not pinned. The saddle
is
stopped the
ceiling.
The splat.
Right. Question. How advanced is the saddle?
As in...
Could I make it?
No.
Okay.
Not yet. I mean, eventually...
Well...
But I do know people.
Yeah.
In fact, I know a whole city of gnomes.
You do know people.
And
I can't figure out anything else, but...
I'm now part of them.
If possible, Rand starts undoing the clasp of the saddle and getting Bark out of there. Like, leave the saddle behind.
Okay.
And just getting him out of there.
That's certainly
until he can,
an option.
If that's... if it's, yeah, that's
now,
what he does.
I could...
He has to, like... Scoot.
Right,
it's
yeah.
Kind of a narrow.
Well, I'm also like help dragging him back.
For the record, I
did a challenge
spend
for me.
Half of my sorcery points, which I'm level 14, I have 14 sorcery points. I can spend half of them to be able to cast teleport a second time, and actually teleport him out of there without the suit. With the suit,
it would only leave us one more charge.
But teleport. Then I can't cast any seventh level spell, and I can't use any sorcery points. Just in case we need to fuck
out.
Well,
Rand isn't thinking straight enough to ask.
How
would
the sorcery points
would Leas actually think to do that?
I get half a short rest, so we can get him back in a day.
Would Leas actually do that?
Absolutely.
Because
well,
Rand isn't
like, what,
thinking enough
hours?
To ask. He's just trying to get Bark
Gerald,
out
what's
there.
A short rest?
Short rest
minutes?
Is about an hour.
Or an hour?
Like
30
minutes to an hour.
Could we not just expend half of them?
Yeah. So
take a short rest and get a half, that half
oh,
back,
yeah.
right?
Then I can half back. Anyway.
Again, Rand's up there
so,
filling
well,
with straps.
We should not rest, though, because what if the strength of the saddle
no.
loses its integrity?
That's
no.
Not
no, he's going to cast teleport, we're going to get Bark out,
oh,
and then
we'll
rest.
Okay,
so,
that's much more
can,
logical.
How are you going to get up there?
I can, like, jump and kind of look and see. I can cast
it's,
it on anything.
I'll jump 25 feet up.
I can, oh, 25
feet. It's 25 feet up, yeah.
Well,
I missed
cast it on to anything in 30 feet of me.
Within 30 feet.
How
yes.
tall are you?
That you can see.
My character?
Yeah.
That
at that point?
I guess.
6 foot.
6 foot? How tall are you?
6 foot.
Okay.
That's still not tall enough.
I'm 5'6".
We're not.
I'm 4'1".
Hold on.
We're not fucking little rasclings this.
Let me get to the spell.
How tall are you?
Can you fly?
Oh, yeah. I can fly.
You have wings
okay.
now.
Oh yeah, I forgot. You
a dragon,
you're a dragon.
Or dragonborn. You have
he's not dragonborn. He has
I win.
His
or
wizard.
He could have just given him the shoes. That also.
Rand's not coming down. You know Rand's not coming down.
Huh?
Yeah, I do.
Or we had
that's
a flying carpet.
Said, I,
or a million other ways to get 25 feet up in the air.
Ways to fly.
Rand isn't coming out of there.
So,
so
you float up, you can see.
I don't remember the
cast.
Shit we have.
Teleport
on both
you
of them. Just teleport down right behind me.
So the saddle,
and it goes.
Yeah.
And then I'll immediately just go ahead and feed Bark a...
The ring, by the way, the ring on the vault door is not, like, inset or anything. It's like a knocker kind of ring.
Okay. I thought you meant, like, an actual ring.
I thought it was, like, a ring, too, yeah.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Sorry, wanted to make sure I clarified
yeah.
that because that can be confusing.
Yeah, well...
So, okay, so suddenly me and Bark are just suddenly down on the floor.
Well, you're on the magic carpet laying soft on the cushy air.
So, to clarify, Rand said, Soren, go ahead and do it. I told you to go ahead and do it. Yeah. And I did it.
There you go.
Yes.
There
right
you
now,
go.
All Rand is doing is clutching Bark and just hugging him. And
yep.
This is what happens when you tell me to do shit.
So, Rand is probably going to be out of commission for a little
no
bit.
Fear
yes.
of poison.
That's why we're going to take a long rest.
Okay, that's fair.
Or a short,
short,
rest.
Rest, short rest.
That's
short
what I meant, short
rest.
Rest. About an hour. And you know what? While we're here, how long will it take? How long did you say it would take us to divvy up the stuff we collected from the chest? About an hour?
About an hour, yeah.
Okay.
But that wouldn't be a short rest. It would be divvying out.
Yeah, that would be...
Could one person do that?
Sure.
Yeah, I'll do it.
Okay.
Right, awesome. So, when
so.
You open the bag of holding and start pulling out
him.
Stuff, you notice that it's different from when you got it out of that room.
Of course it is.
What's
yeah.
it look like?
So, each of the gems you actually see are quartz, worth about 1 gold piece each.
Sounds about right.
So we have 10,000 gold pieces. 10,000 okay.
gold worth of quartz. And the platinum is actually copper.
I figured that was going to happen
copper.
Too.
10,000
cool. leprechaun gold.
Yeah. Cool.
10,000 gold.
Is there any, like, permanent damage to Bark's armor?
That's 2,000 gold each, though.
Good question. You don't know. You haven't tried any of the buttons yet.
Okay, gotcha.
Huh.
That's 2,000 gold each, though, right?
I believe so.
I don't care enough about that. I care more about Bark.
Okay.
I'm still cuddling. Okay.
Still cuddling, yes.
Hmm.
Cool beans. Now.
That's 10 gold, so good luck with that.
Time. We're almost out of time. This will be our last part of this.
Yeah.
A couple of things will happen really quickly for the sake of expediting the process, because you have ridiculous perception rules. this is not a trapped door in any way. It's not even locked. You can hard pull open the door.
Thank you.
A low dust-covered bench is near the back wall of the vault. On and around it are an abundance of items. Resting on one end of it is a human skull.
Mm. Da, da, da.
The items...
Dad.
We will get... we'll get to later. Because they're really nice items, actually. And I gotta come up with some of these things. Some of them are scrolls, some of them are...
Just you're saying you gotta make shit up.
There's a bunch of sweet leaks.
You gotta make shit up.
I do.
We got rare drops, boys.
You do got rare drops. That's very true.
Also, which I didn't know was a store in town that's apparently really fucking awesome.
How did you not know?
Been there for a while, bro.
I
been
know.
Here for like 2.5 years.
Zach and Hassan were telling me about it the other day.
Yeah, it's like my favorite store in Huntington.
Amazing. Never knew. And it's right by the union. Where I drink every week.
Right by you, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, it's where, right by where I drink every week.
The union.
And I still didn't know about it.
Let me make a quick couple quick notes here. We're out of time. So we will get to that lovely stockpile of loot in the next session in 2 weeks. So, later!
Bye!
Adios!
Bye, friends.